If you've ever tried following a moving subject with a drone, or even just a camera, you know how hard it could be to keep your subject in the middle of the frame. On top of that, if you want to zoom in on your subject, it makes it exponentially harder. Lucky for us, this can easily be done in post-production using the FCPX Auto-Zoom 2.1 plugin from the sponsor of this video, Pixel Film Studios. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and welcome back to my channel. Today, we'll be taking a look at the newly updated FCPX Auto-Zoom 2.1 plugin from Pixel Film Studios. This plugin includes professional zooming tools combined with auto-tracking and allows you to smoothly zoom in on the action of your shot, smooth out your drone follow shots, even stabilize and track handheld clips. Let's jump into Final Cut Pro and see what we can do with this plugin. We'll start off with a simple example of a drone following a driving car. The shot itself isn't bad, but if we place a rectangle over the subject, you can see just how much the camera moves around in the shot. Let's apply the FCPX Auto-Zoom plugin and see if we can fix it. Now, there's two ways to apply this plugin. You can either apply it as an effect directly to your clip, or as an adjustment layer. Let's do an adjustment layer first. From the Titles and Generators browser, select the Zoom In adjustment layer and press Q to connect it to your timeline. Ripple trim it to the length of your clip. Next, with the adjustment layer clip selected, move your playhead to the start of the clip, head up to the video inspector, and select the Titles inspector. First thing we need to do is track our clip. Click the Track Editor button to open the tracking window, position the tracking square over your subject, and adjust its shape. Bring the track quality slider all the way up for best tracking results and hit the track forward button. The Auto Tracker 2.0 tracks every frame of your clip and creates keyframe for your subject's position. After the track is complete, click the Export Data button to export these keyframes to your timeline. Next, back up in the inspector, scroll down to the zoom controls, select the on-off checkbox, and set your zoom amount. If you use the slider, it maxes out at 32, but you can go much higher by either clicking and dragging up the number beside it, or by manually entering the value. Let's zoom in by 100. By default, your track subject is centered in the frame. Since ours started out closer to the bottom, our frame was moved up until a subject was in the middle. To fill a frame where the clip cuts off, FCPX Auto-Zoom creates a mirror effect of our clip. This works on certain clips, but most of the time, it just looks weird. There's a couple ways to fix this. If you have the extra resolution, you can just zoom in more on your clip until the mirror part is out of the frame. If you don't have the extra resolution or don't want to change the zoom amount, you can offset the position of your subject. In Zoom Controls section, adjust the X and the Y offset sliders until a mirrored part of your clip is out of the frame. This moves your subject, but still keeps it in the same spot throughout your entire clip for a perfect follow shot. And last, you can make the camera zoom appear more realistic by adding some motion blur, simulating camera autofocus, or even adding a bit of camera shake to your clip during the zoom. You can also change the duration and the smoothness of your zoom in the custom speed control section of the inspector to ease in and out. Our finished result is a perfect zoom-in drone follow shot. Nice and simple. Let's try another clip, and this time a bit harder. Ever watch a hockey or a football game, and a camera zooms in on and follows a specific player while keeping them perfectly centered in the frame? These kinds of shots take a lot of practice and are extremely hard to execute. FCPX Auto-Zoom makes this much easier. Let's focus on player number 16 in our next clip. First, skim your clip and make sure the player doesn't get too close to the edge or leave the frame. Next, move your playhead to the start of your clip and apply the FCPX Auto-Zoom plugin. Let's use the effect this time and apply it directly to our clip. Select the clip and head up to the inspector. First thing we need to do is track our player. Open the track editor and select the part of your player that's visible at all times, such as his helmet. Set the track quality slider to 100% and hit the track forward button. Sometimes, when the track part of your subject becomes obstructed, or something very similar moves in too close, the auto tracker may lose your subject. This is easily fixed. As soon as you lose track, hit the stop button to stop tracking. Zoom in on your timeline, and use the back arrow key to go back to the last frame where the tracker is in the right position. Add keyframes to offset X and Y. Next, hold down the Shift key and drag out a box around all the keyframes after that. Delete these keyframes by right-clicking and selecting Remove Keyframes. Move ahead one frame at a time and reposition the box over your subject. Keep doing this until all the obstructions clear up. Hit the Track Forward button again and let AutoTracker finish tracking your subject. Depending on your clip, you may have to do this more than once. Once your track is finished, hit the Export Data button to apply all the tracking keyframes to your clip. Next, in the inspector, enable zoom controls and set the amount of zoom. Add some motion blur and other camera effects for a more realistic zoom. Let your clip render out and you're done. You've just created a perfect camera zoom and track shot of your selected player, something that's nearly impossible to do with just your camera when filming. The FCPX Auto-Zoom 2.1 plugin can be a very handy tool to have in your toolbox for polishing your shots. We've barely scratched the surface of what you can do with it in this video. If you want to try this plugin when checking out, make sure to use the coupon code SURGEPIXEL for 30% off your purchase. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting the like button and subscribing to my channel. And once again, a big thank you to Pixel Film Studios for making this plugin and sponsoring this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys back here next week.